H.C. Verma, Chapter 8, Question Number 53. The bob of a pendulum at rest is given a sharp hit to impart a horizontal velocity of root 10 gL, where L is the length of the pendulum. Find the tension in the string when A, the string is horizontal, B, the bob is at the highest point, and C, the string makes an angle of 60 degrees with the upward vertical. Let us denote the speed of the bob at the lowest position by V0. Also, assume the speed of the bob when the string is horizontal to be V1. The kinetic energy of the bob at this point is half mv1 square. As you can see, when the string is horizontal, it is at a height L from the lowest position of the bob. So, if we take the lowest position of the bob as zero potential line, then the potential energy of the string when it is horizontal is mgL. Also, as at the lowest position, the bob is at zero potential line moving the speed V0. Its total initial mechanical energy is half mv0 square. Thus, as per conservation of energy, half mv1 square plus mgL is equal to half mv0 square. The value of v0 is root 10 gL. Dividing both sides by half m, we get v1 square plus 2 gL is equal to 10 gL, or v1 square is equal to 8 gL. Now, let us draw the free body diagram of the bob. Since the bob is moving in a circular path of radius L, a centrifugal force of mv1 square by L will act on it in horizontal direction. Tension in the string will pull the block towards center. There will be gravity in vertical direction, but our concern here is to calculate tension which is in horizontal direction, so we are not drawing it. Balancing the forces in horizontal direction, we get T is equal to mv1 square by L. Putting the value of v1 square, we get T is equal to 8 mg. This is answer to part A of the question. In part B, the bob is at the highest position. Let its velocity at this point be V2. As the height of the bob from the lowest position is 2L, the mechanical energy of the bob at this point is half mv2 square plus 2 mgL, which must be equal to half mv0 square or half m into 10 gL. Dividing both sides by half m, we get v2 square plus 4 gL is equal to 10 gL or v2 square is equal to 6 gL. In the free body diagram of the bob, centrifugal force of mv2 square by L acts on the bob in upward direction, gravity of mg acts downward, and tension T in the string is in downward direction. Balancing the forces in vertical direction, we get mv2 square by L is equal to mg plus T. Putting the values of v2 square, we get 6 mg is equal to mg plus T, or T is equal to 5 mg. This is answer to part B of the question. In part C, the string makes angle 60 degree with the upward vertical. As cos 60 degrees is 1 by 2, the height of the bob above the point of suspension is L by 2. Thus, the bob is at height of 3L by 2 from the lowest position. If V3 be the speed of the bob at this position, then its total mechanical energy at this point is half mv3 square plus 3 mgL by 2, which must be equal to half mv0 square or half m into 10 gL. Dividing both sides by half m, we get v3 square plus 3 gL is equal to 10 gL or v3 square is equal to 7 gL. Now, let us draw the free body diagram of the bob. Centrifugal force of mv3 square by L acts in radially outward direction. Gravitational force of mg acts in vertically downward direction. As the gravity makes angle 60 degree with the string, the component of gravity towards the center is mg cos theta. Tension in the string T acts along the string towards center. Balancing the forces along the string, we get mv3 square by L is equal to T plus mg cos 60 degree. Putting the values of V3 and cos 60 degree, we get 7 mg is equal to T plus mg by 2. Simplifying, we get T is equal to 13 mg by 2. This is our answer. In order to request solution to any question from H.C. Verma book, post the question number and chapter number in comments below. Like and share the video to help other students find us. Subscribe our channel, like our Facebook page, and follow us on Twitter for latest updates. Thank you for watching.